A special honor took place in Carruthers tonight to remember the victims of the Wisconsin Parade Massacre. A moment of silence was held before the town's annual Lights Parade. Tonight, both the towns of Carruthers and Reedley kicked off their holiday seasons. CBS 47's Juanita Adame has more.
Carruthers celebrated the start of their holiday season with their light parade and Winterfest event. The holidays are here, and two local towns celebrated in big ways. In Carruthers, the light parade made its way back into town.
This is enjoyment. It brings joy. Everybody comes down to the parade, but they go back to the fairgrounds for our Winterfest. Last year with COVID, we weren't able to have it. People were disappointed, calling us very upset. This year, we did bigger and better.
Reedley's Electrical Farm Equipment Parade also made its comeback after the pandemic.
This is what Reedley does, and so I don't know if we went all out, but we are having a great time out here. We've had great entertainment. We've have community, and it's just been awesome with our new Christmas tree and this new event of Christmas in the Park in downtown Reedley.
A moment of silence kicked off the Carruthers Light Parade. This was done to honor the victims of the Waukesha, Wisconsin Parade Massacre.
The moment silence can take in remembrance of the people who were killed at their Christmas parade in Wisconsin. We decided one day the sheriff department called me and I said that was something we were planning.
Guests like Carol Wenstrand and Donna Becerra were among the attendees in Carruthers.
I love it. Absolutely love it.
I'm here. My nephew is the FFA teacher here, Matt Winstrand, and I wanted to support the Carruthers community because I've done a few of their fairs here, and they're a great community.
The parades brought back a sense of normalcy that locals were anxiously anticipating following the year-long break due to COVID.
Looking forward to just all the entries and stuff. I'm just having a good time.
The parade route began here at the corner of Tahoe and Oak and made its way down Tahoe to the Carruthers Fairgrounds for Winterfest. Reporting in Carruthers, Juanita Adame, CBS 47 Eyewitness News.